Hello everyone and welcome to my first Unity tutorial of how to make menu from different games. Today we will create menu from Minecraft, so let's get started. The first thing we need to do is import the resources we need. To do this, we drop the images into assets folder, and then in the settings, change the texture type value to the sprite, and the sprite mode value to multiple, telling Unity that we are dealing with several sprites in one file. Before we can use this image, we need to select three kinds of buttons from it. So go to the sprite editor and... Oh, it looks like we don't have some packages installed that are easy to find in the package manager. Well, no problem. Install them and continue. Click sprite editor again and finally get into the editor window. Here we just need to select our three button textures along with the fields. So we can get three different sprites from one object. And now, finally, we can create our button. In the menu, click the game object, then UI and a button. Let's increase the size and apply our sprite to it. Well, this is not what I expected. The quality of the button is too poor. To fix this, you need to change the filter mode to point, set the pixel per unit to 16 and compression to none. Pretty nice. Our button has become much sharper. But what if we need a small button? As you already remember, we set the borders for our buttons, thanks to which Unity now understands when they need to be extended. So just change the image type to the tiled and increase its value a bit. Also increase the size of the text, change its color to white. Then we need to add a shadow to our button and change its effect distance a bit. And the original font from Minecraft. And now, if we hit play, we can notice that button changes color when hovered and pressed, but not the one we need. In order to fix this, select the transition sprite swap and drop the highlight button here. In addition, it was changing the navigation property of the button to none, so that does not retain focus. Well done! Now we have a fully functional button. The next step is to add a background. To do this, we use a dirt texture, just like in old versions of Minecraft. In the import settings, we again indicate that it is sprite, set a point filter and 16 pixels per unit. However, this time, change the wrap mode value to repeat to make a continuous background from the ground. To add a background to scene, click again to the game object, UI, and select panel. Then we drag the texture, set the image type tiled, and change the color to darker one. Excellent! But our button disappeared somewhere. Let's move the background to a layer below. So that our button doesn't feel lonely, we can create even more buttons. And here it is. Now we have one button to generate new level, the second to load it, the third to go to the options, and the fourth to start the tutorial, which is disabled. To make such a button, you need to drag the first sprite to the place of the image, and uncheck the box next to interactable in the settings. It looks cool, but something is missing. Well, we really forgot to add a logo. Let's fix this. Considering the parallel steps, adding a logo is the easiest one. We simply indicate again that it's sprite, create new image, and move sprite to the stage. Somehow it turned out small. Let's ask Unity to fix it. Click on the set native size button and increase it a little. All that remains is to add a text to our logo, which will soon show random labels. Well done! This step completes our main menu. But you didn't think it was the end. Let's add the settings menu, but before that, let's group all our buttons and logo together, for convenience, and rename panel and image as well. The settings menu will consist entirely of the buttons that we have already created in advance. And now, let's get into the details. Let's start with the label in the main menu. It should increase and decrease, as well as change the text when you go to menu from options. First, let's create an animation that will resize our text. In a recording mode, after 30 seconds, we will reduce the size to 0.85. And after 30 seconds, we will return it back. Let's play the animation and see. Well, not bad. Let's create a script that will have functions for our buttons and text control. Name it menu. In order to interact with the main menu and the settings menu, we need the corresponding objects. Let's declare them. Also, for each button, we will create its own function that this button will call. In order to show options, we need to hide our main menu object and showOptions object, and vice versa for hideOptions function. Drag our script onto the canvas object, then drag the main menu and settings menu to the corresponding fields. Then, for all buttons described in our script, we need to add this corresponding function to onClick. To do this, click the plus icon, drag the object with the newly created script, and select the desired function. For example, for the Options button, it will be Show Options, and for the Done button in the Options menu, select Hide Options. Now we can move freely between the Settings menu and the Main menu. Excellent! Next, let's go back to the label and add a random text change to it. When we want to interact not just with objects, but with the UI components of Unity, we need to use unityengine.ui. Now we can declare the text to work with. We will change the text in two cases, at the beginning and when returning to the menu. Let's create the changeText function and the array of values for our label, from where the function will take the text. Now, using random.range, into which we will pass the beginning and the end of the array, just take a random text and put it in our label. Then we need to call our function in the start function to change the text when the menu starts, and in the hideOption function to change text when we reshow it. After that, move our label to the appropriate field and press play. Cool! Our label has now played with new colors. The menu looks good enough already, but something is still missing. Let's add music and click sounds. In order to add music, you need to create an empty object, add an our source component which will play it, after which we will tell the new component what exactly we want to play. And the play on awake flag will do it right at the start of the scene. We do the same for the object that will play the clicks. But this time, remove the play on awake flag, so the click sound will be heard only when the button is pressed. Next, select all the buttons that we have, add a new event to them on your click, drag the click controller there, and select play in the functions. Now our menu plays music in the background, and also responds to a click by playing a sound. And the last thing we need to do is to create two similar functions in our script to adjust them. Let's start by declaring variables. We will need two audio source objects to decrease and increase the volume, as well as two text objects through which we will inform the user of the current volume position. The function will check the current volume and, depending on it, will either increase or decrease it, as well as change the button text after completion. Let's do the same for sounds, just changing the variables. Now we just need to drag the components into our script and add the corresponding functions to the onclick of our buttons. And now, finally, we can see what we got. Excellent! We've got a menu just like in earlier versions of Minecraft. Well, that's pretty much it for this video. Thank you for watching, and if you like this tutorial, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, where there will be many more interesting things. I will see you in the next video.